Hi friends, Jessie here from jessiebanks.com, and welcome back to another video. So, happy New Year's Eve, everybody. That's when this one's going live. I decided to pull out the Be Kind stamp set here from Simon Says Stamp, and I have some sticky back canvas. It's not very sticky. Also, this clip is a weird color. Not sure why. Anyway, I'm going to take some watercolor ground that I promptly poured all over the place, including my floor, and just so the front of it, well, put the watercolor ground on the front of the canvas paper here, just so that it is absorbent like watercolor. I will give it a couple of coats of this. This one was super fun, you guys, and I thought, being New Year's Eve, being the end of what I guess will be the disaster of 2020, and hoping things will get better at some point in time in 2021, I pulled out the Be Kind stamp set from Simon Says Stamp. I will have all the products linked in the description box below if you're interested in anything. But I thought this one would be perfect, so I brought it out and I grabbed this leaf out of the center. I don't think I've ever colored this little leaf stem up, and I'm going to ink it up with some antique linen distress ink. And we're going to stamp that down right into the middle. And then I'm pulling out my Stone Ground Paint Company paints. I did swatch a bunch of these out that I'm going to use. I ended up not using two of those five colors, but I do use the yellow ochre, the felsite, and the Prussian blue out of these. And you'll see my process here. I'm just putting the yellowy color towards the tip of the leaf and the blue in the base of the leaf. And we're just going to blend them back and forth and kind of mix them together a little bit. This was super fun. This card came together super fast. I think it was like a 20-minute card all said and done, 20, 25 minutes. So yeah, it was kind of a blast just to put together really quick, really simple. And I really love the way this one came out. I might actually have to do this again on another card. I think it's just so pretty. It actually, in the end, looks almost like, well, as you saw in the picture at the beginning, like the sprig of leaves has actually popped up on top of the card as opposed to being painted right on top of it. Now, watercoloring on top of this, while it was much like watercolor paper for blending and stuff because of the watercolor ground, it did spread out much more because of the texture in the canvas. I didn't put enough ground on top to get rid of that texture completely, so you still have that linen hatching in the texture of the canvas. But I think it looks really pretty, and I kind of like that it's a little bit messy and not quite so neat. And once I go in with my Inktense pencils a little bit later on in the video, I just think it worked so well, and I was really happy that it was a little imperfect, I guess is the word I'm looking for. So this is Prussian blue that I'm starting off with here and just putting a light layer of it in the bottom. Then I come back with the felsite, I think it's how it's pronounced. I think it's felsite. Hang on. F-E-L-S-I-T-E. Felsite. That's what I'm going with. Just to deepen up the ochre color at the tips of the leaves. And then I will take the Prussian blue again and put a little more shadow in the depths of the blue part of the leaves as well. Just giving it a little more depth of color instead of being quite so washed out. I think it made a big difference personally, and I'm really happy with it. So I do show you some of this a little bit slower at 2.5, and then on most of the colors, I'm cranking it up to like 6 times the speed that it was originally, because I don't have that much to talk about. So, and it gets pretty repetitive because it's the same thing on every leaf. So we'll get all of those painted up, and then I will pull out my Inktense pencils. I haven't used my Inktense in a very long time. I like them. I've always enjoyed them. I just need to remember to use them a little bit more. That's something I've been focusing on in the last little while, is using things I haven't in a while. So this is the Inktense pencil set, and I'm going to pull out the oak pencil as well as the sepia ink pencil. And those are the two we're going to use here. So I'm going to start off with the oak pencil, and I'm going to put a little shading at the bottom of the leaves, as you can see, and then trace out the entire stem as well. And then we'll crank up the speed so that we don't have to watch it at a painfully low place or slow pace. And I'm just following the artist drawn lines. I'm following exactly how they have it drawn out, adding a little bit of shading to the bottom of the leaf over top of that blue, and then tracing the stems. Now I'm just going to put a tiny little bit of water on this brush, and I'm just going to go over top of that in order to set it so it looks more like watercolor as opposed to pencil, but it was a little neater than trying to paint those super thin lines with my watercolors. Now I'm going to go through, and I'm dipping my sepia pencil here in water so that it's really, really thick and traced over bits and pieces. And then we're back into the oak and I'm creating a drop shadow underneath of all those leaves. So I'm just putting in a little tiny line and then I'll go back with the paintbrush here and blend it out a little bit so it looks more like a shadow. And that's how it looks like they pop off the page. And I think the look really worked and I'm super excited that it turned out the way I wanted it to turn out. So that was really, really fun. Now I'm going to pull out a scrap of this sticky back canvas and I'm going to pull out the sentiment strip that says, "In a world where you can be anything, dot, dot, dot." And we're going to use the khaki ink pad from Simon Says Stamp in order to stamp that on to the very top here. Cut it out in a little strip. I don't think the strip was straight, but that's okay. Now I have the Be Kind stamp set and I'm going to stamp that out with the same khaki ink. And then I decide that it wasn't dark enough because it doesn't pop off the page in front of that sprig of leaves. So I'm going to go back in with that sepia Inktense pencil and I'm going to just trace over top of all of that. So we'll glue that down onto an A2 size top folding card base. Add our little sentiment strip here at the top. I didn't put water to set the pencil on the sentiment. I didn't think it needed it, so I just left it as it was. And that's the end of this one, guys. So if you have any questions, definitely leave them down below. If you aren't subscribed to the channel, I'd love for you to subscribe. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. And if you're looking for any of the products, they'll be in the description box below. Bye for now.